Hey folks, we're back near Dryden, Ontario in Wabigoon Lake with Merkel's camp. But we're finally here on the last leg of a nice long trip to Northwest Ontario. And man, I'm looking forward to it. Walleyes, smallmouth bass, crappie, you name it, it's here. Terry knows where to go, gonna jump in his boat, have some fun, and think about this place where these hardworking folk put together the type of resort that you're gonna make memories with your family, your friends, your buddies, you name it. This is their 60th year anniversary. Think about that, man. 60 years in this location, providing for customers like you and I with some fantastic fishing accommodations. So without further ado, let's break out the rods, head out in the lake, have some fun with Terry at Merkel's camp, catching everything that wants to bite. Let's do it. Okay, Terry is telling me that these walleyes and smallmouth and crappie are so close to shore, so shallow, and very aggressive. So yeah, we're gonna bring the meat on board, you know, some night crawlers and minnows and maybe leeches, you know, standard fare for Northwest Ontario, but little curly tail grubs, just the little guys, 1/8 ounce, 3/16 ounce jigs. I got it to some fluorocarbon, to main braid, some of your favorite spinning rods, 6'6", 7 foot, medium power, smooth reel, but that's all we're gonna need. So I've rigged up some different colors, with different tones, offsetting, pearls with chartreuse. Okay, Terry, what's the deal? Are we gonna drift or anchor, or are you just gonna use the trolling motor?
Well, typically how I fish it, I just go along the shoreline and just fast enough to keep moving along.
Yep.
And I cast right up into the shore.
Okay.
And then you'll pull it back off and drop it down. And you'll find out if the fish are in like 2 feet of water, 4, 5, 6, okay, whatever that way.
Okay.
You start getting hints.
Okay. And last but not least, a couple jigs that we gotta put on the meat. Fish are biting slow. I got 1/8 ounce as well, orange chartreuse, similar rod, and one that makes by Northern Tackle Company. Josh makes those custom little jigs that, man, they are just the best I've ever used. A little bit of blue sparkle, blue eyes with chartreuse. We're gonna catch fish on Wabigoon. There's a fish. Ooh, it doesn't feel bad either. Whoa, 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 what are you?
Northern.
Walleye, smallmouth. I think I saw some brown, you know that? Can't tell. Nope, northern again.
Is it?
Yep, it loves the fire tiger, huh?
We'll net it, because those things break.
Oh no, walleye. Ooh, wise walleye too, huh?
There we go.
Whoa, very nice. Wow, I'm impressed, Terry. This is awesome, man. Not hurting him. Look at that, just on the outside. He likes the crazy clown color too. Look at that. Nice way to start, right on the edge of those rocks too, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
3 feet of water that was in.
Wow.
There you go,
what
sir.
A way to start. So, do we just gonna catch and release today?
Whatever you want to
like,
do.
Like, what are the sizes here?
You can have a slot. That's in the slot size right now.
So that has to let go.
It has to go back in. 18 to 23 okay. Is in the slot size for.
Okay. And anything under what? 14.
18.
For keeping what?
For keeping, I keep 14s to 16s is what I usually for okay. Eating wise. That's what I like to eat.
Impressive, man. Impressive. I thought it was a little northern again because they seem to like the bright, obnoxious. Told you that little thing would find fish. Right on the edge of those rocks. Doink! I lifted it once, falling down. Doink! And Terry, oh.
Might want to get the net for this.
Net?
Yeah.
Man. Oh, well, just nice walleye,
not
huh?
Not nearly as big as I thought it was.
Just a fighter, hey? Yeah.
It really pulled, I don't know if maybe that northern grab something, it just feels really heavy. That's a thick fish though.
Yeah, no kidding.
Oh, sorry. There we go. There's a walleye. Just getting on the edge of the eating size one, sir. I started guiding when I was 8 years old, and I started cooking shore lunch at 10. Honestly, I did, yeah.
So you've seen a few shore lunches,
oh,
eh?
Oh, yeah. And everybody feels sorry for me because I would never really have a big plate full of fish, but I'd eat a little bit here and there, and then I'd have all the stuff that's left in the frying pan, That was the best part of it.
Yeah. Now this little thing, this lake has some color to it. Depending on how deep we fish, it don't matter. The orange chartreuse with the fire tiger, bright chartreuse tail, slowly crawl, drop, cast, retrieve, you name it. This thing is gonna catch me fish on Wabigoon. There's one.
Got him.
Oh, look at the size of this northern. Or is that a muskie? Will you see this? Oh, I just saw it for a second, dude. I saw it for a second. It was like, you wanna see me? Oh, we'll be right there.
That's northern, yeah.
Look at that. Oh, look what he's got in his mouth. No, he's got the walleye, dude.
Oh, yeah?
He's got the walleye that I hooked. Watch this.
Yeah.
Watch this.
Just like we were talking about,
yeah.
Eh? In distress.
See, watch when you see the fish. Look.
There, see?
Look at that
oh,
walleye.
Oh, I got... He let go of it.
And I...
I almost got him.
Look at that.
That was about a 30.
Now, look at that.
Yeah.
That's what happens.
Well,
you've
eat
seen
that
on this
one.
Trip,
yeah.
Eh? Yeah, man. Wow, what a northern, eh?
That was about 36, 38.
I've seen it on a few times this trip. I didn't, at one place he's saying, don't reach down. And because I felt the walleye first, right? Lifting up. All of a sudden it was like, clamp. It's like, oh no, okay.
Oh, I just lost mine.
This one is going to be an eater. You have to respect it.
Yeah.
Trauma.
We'll eat him up.
Go on. And you talk about walleye fishing, man, how much fun it is. I always said, you know, you become a better fisherman when you learn how to fish walleye, how to fish slow, how to work it. Sometimes there's just 5-10 minute lulls between nothing because those fish are either moving or you're just off those places where the fish are positioned based on the wind coming in. And this is perfect where we are. Wind blowing in, nice little breeze, the typical walleye chop, and these fish are scattered all throughout the front of this island. Good one?
That's a little better one. A little bit better.
We're sitting in 5, 4. Whoa.
You might want to get the net first.
I'll get the net. I'll get the net. When you ask, then I get it. If you don't ask, I won't get it. Isn't that what you said?
I haven't seen it yet, but it'll be...
Very northern?
No, it feels like about 18, 20 inch walleye. Like
oh, very nice walleye. Yeah, man. Oh, yeah, Terry. Wow. Look at the thickness of that fish. Beautiful fish.
Yeah, that was 4 feet of water.
Wow. Wabigoon walleye. Huh? Yeah, man.
Nice little fish.
We'll let him go. Bye, fish. Right on, man.
You gotta get all the rocks.
Good stuff. One of the things we're using, real light jigs, okay, 1/8 ounce, because we're fishing between 8, 10, 12 feet of water. You gotta, one thing about walleye fishing, you learn to become a better fisherman because you need to feel the jig on the bottom. If you go to a heavier jig, you might be frustrated, but again, that's a rock, you know? So we're fishing a lot of vertical stuff or short pitches. And again, another thing is we don't make real long pitches when you drag it through. So we're just making, I don't know, 20 feet each side of the boat, just pitching it out, okay? You just watch it down, you let it go down, make a short pitch, let it go down. And this way you can just keep it just above the bottom where most of those crappie or walleye or smallmouth are, and just shake the tip a bit, move it a bit, and you stay out of those rocks and you stay away from frustration. Goes a long way. And again, there's shallower water here. It's an excellent way to have some fun catching walleyes and everything else here in Wabigoon.
And these been coming, the ice kids are coming.
Oh yeah. Just a nice one, but better be careful, he's on the surface there. Got Mr. Pike around. Ooh, he got lucky again through the schnoz. Whoa, hold on, buddy, hold on. Oh, gill rakers.
Yeah.
Hey? Sunset Country. Little fire tiger, catch me some fish. Terry's getting them on the meat. I just wanted to see with this water clarity, you know, from experience of fishing up in these areas here, that you can't beat a curly tail grub. Depending on the depth, working it slow, just hopping it and shaking it a bit like that. It's all about getting those walleyes to see the bait. Once they see the bait, you're 50% there. Because most times you're gonna come over, boom, or you just feel a little light sponge, lift up, put the pressure, make sure the metal meets the meat, and you catch those walleyes. There he is.
You're saying, how do the fish find those minnows? I said, you don't realize how many fish are actually down there.
Mm-hmm.
When you figure there's 18 different species of just bait fish in the lake besides the game fish.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta go to a twister tail. I'm losing up a lot of minnows here. But that's okay.
Okay, first spot, maybe 100 yard stretch. The lodge is right over there. Terry says, "Tell you're not gonna go far." Told me last night when we first came in, got me all excited over dinner about where we're gonna fish. He wasn't whistling Dixie, seriously. One stretch, some fantastic pike action, some big pike. Sauger, walleyes, like there's no tomorrow, all different sizes and stuff. So far, so good.
And
that one is, I'm not sure what that is. I got a feeling it's big northern.
Nice size.
Oh boy. I think it is. It bit you, and then I'm pretty sure it's northern. No, oh no, nice walleye. Wow. What a fighter.
There we go.
Walleye. Wow.
There we go.
That's a nice walleye, eh? Hit it like a northern too. Wow. Take a quick picture and let her go. Just tip of that little bit of skin. We'll just respectfully let her go. Right here. Hey, look at that, eh? What a gorgeous walleye. Oh, nice slap too. Wow, man. Terry was right, man. Come to these little spots like that. Still textbook. That fish was as shallow. Terry just got one that was maybe a foot and a half of water. Small fish, doesn't matter. But with the wind, so instead of throwing on the outsides of 8, 9, 10 feet, threw into about 3, 4 feet. And the bite felt like a northern dung. But the scrap, walleyes do fight.
We have two guys that come, they'll be here in July, they come up. But they drove by, he said, for 20-something years. They finally stopped in one day just to check it out. That was about 10 years ago. And
I see why.
But they used to go up to, they went up to Lac Seul all the times where they fished.
Sure.
He said, yeah, we don't catch a big one sometimes, but we don't have to travel.
Yeah, it's really like, fun.
We're not even a mile from camp. You know?
Yeah, look at the first spot, how many fish we got.
Yeah. You don't have to go far at all.
Nope, there's one there. And it is, good walleye too. Oh, yeah. As soon as you get near that point again, it's just a nice one. Terry, look.
Yeah, those are nice.
Hey?
Yeah. There we go.
It's just when I lifted up on him, he just felt bigger. But I ain't complaining. I'm having a blast. There he is.
There we go.
That's nice it. One. Hey, yeah. Wabigoon. Go on, buddy. Oh yeah, nice and healthy. Getting her done. Whew. What have we been out? Like 3 hours maybe?
Yeah.
Or something like that. How many different fish we caught? All kinds of sizes, variety.
We caught close to 40 fish.
Yeah. I'd say. Wow. So stick around. From Wabigoon Lake, near Dryden, we are gonna have some fun at Merkel's camp. We'll be right back. All right, we go back to the same spot where yesterday. Why change? You know, Terry says, you know, you don't move to fish to find fish when you're on fish, even though he's fished this lake his whole life. I said, you know what? Let's go back to the same spots. And right away, the pike are there, slashing at baits. We're catching some walleyes, even getting some netted walleyes. I hear some drag.
Yeah, a little nice. Pikey? A little head shake like a pike. But
walleye?
Could be a nice walleye. I think it's a walleye, yep.
Yeah? Netter? Okay.
Yeah, a little bit better. I don't know. Maybe 17 inches or so, 18. Won't be too big. But
yeah, that's a nice walleye.
Yeah.
On the pinky. Pink and white. Oh, yeah. Terry's got it changed up. Here, show them that lure net.
Pink and white. Pick that up. It's nice when you get them right on the edge of the lip, either top or bottom or side. The side is the easiest one to get out. You get them on top and bottom, they get a little more cartilage on them. But yeah, real nice fish.
Gorgeous fish.
Hey.
Way to go. Now, fishing with baits like this, 1/8 ounce, based on the depth we're fishing, anywhere between, I'm casting this up to 3 feet and bringing it down to over the 12 foot on the edge of those rock little points and shoals and stuff. And basically, it's like fishing live bait. Really is. Pitching it out, lift, drop, lift drop. But one thing about fishing a little bit bigger bait like this, it's a little about 2.5 inch or so, you seem to get some of those bigger bites.
Oh!
Got him. Just finished saying it too, eh? I think it's maybe, no, it's. I'm pretty sure it's a walleye. We'll find out in a minute. Oh, it is too. Look at that. That's a nice one.
Oh, that's a nice one, yeah.
He took that too, eh? Look at that.
He inhaled it, but it looks
I just finished saying it too. Here he is. Thank you, sir. Whew. Oh, yeah. Wow. I'm going to show you where he got that. Look at that little bait. Gonzo, eh? Take the hook out. Quick pictures. Beautiful golden bars. Back in Wabigoon. Ready, buddy? Ready? Ready? Go on. Gone but not forgotten. Man, the second morning, we'll be up here for a really short trip. But Terry said we're going to catch walleyes. Not far. Lodge is just over there. Having some fun. Simplest way to catch walleyes. Ball head jigs, some plastics, and some bait. A little bit more, and the trip will be over. But I tell you, never forgotten, because I am coming back, whether they want me or not. And the bites are just like the traditional lift, drop, and boom, like lightning, right down to your wrist. Never miss those ones.
Hi, welcome to Merkel's Camp. We've been here, this is our 60th anniversary, and we've been here for most of the whole time of it. Terry made the road in here, and his grandparents started the camp, and we've continued it.
My grandfather always told me that I was the first person to step on the property. We came across the lake by boat, and I jumped out, and we walked up the hill. It was September, and I can remember all the birch trees and the yellow leaves. You want to build a camp? I said, sure. What's the little kid going to say? I didn't know I was committed to working all the rest of my life. It's been an excellent lake for us for fishing-wise and for vacationing. It's not a real super busy lake. It's easy to fish. So a lot of people that come up that aren't super good fishermen that want a vacation with a family, typically we fish a mile to 3 miles from camp. And it gives you walleye, northerns, there's muskies, smallmouth, perch, crappie, everything's there for you.
Yeah.
And you can fish shallow. That's the nice thing. Deep is 12 feet pretty much for us.
In conclusion, I guess we just want to invite anyone who wants to come and experience northwestern Ontario and the Wabigoon Lake chain.
There's 40 miles of water between Wabigoon and Dunork and 9 lakes you get to by boat.
Give us a call.
Now I'm having fun. This place is unique, just like every other region, every other lodge. Each place has its own amenities, uniqueness. But when I can hook it up with the owner of the lodge, Terry, like I do with some of the guides and other owners of other lodges, you know, they go out of their way to make sure that I can provide a great show, put me on fish, and inspire you to think about your vacations. But throwing little baits, plastic baits, and live bait, doesn't matter. There's so many walleye up here in Sunset Country, it'll boggle your mind.
Got him?
Yep. That's a pretty big fish. Yeah.
Sorry.
That's walleye. It's pretty big. I don't know. It's actually fighting kind of like a walleye here.
Yeah, it's staying down, eh?
Can see my line, Terry? Yeah, right there.
There's a walleye.
Oh, big walleye, boy. Oh,
get in there.
Oh, no.
Get in there.
Okay, let's try it.
Oh. There we go.
Oh, yes. Wow.
Merrill Island.
Merrill, thank you.
Merrill pulled through again.
Merrill from Merkel's. Holy moly, look at the size of that walleye, dude. We're gonna take some pictures, let this fish go. But that's the kind of fish. Whew! Merkel's Camp, eh? Wow! Wabigoon walleye. What a way to end our trip up here in Northwest Ontario with some giant, beautiful, big walleyes. Some pictures, and we'll let this big, beautiful baby go. Beautiful, gorgeous Look at the thickness of that walleye. Wow. Go on, baby. Well, what do you think now? Hey? Wow. Wabigoon walleye. What an adventure. A fantastic road trip. Got to meet Merrill and Terry over here, Merkel's camp. But I mean, the walleyes are incredible everywhere on this lake, man. But the sizes and all different, and pike. And maybe we won't play for crappie next time we come, but the amount of excitement on the pike, those big walleyes like that, how can you beat it? Think about it next time you plan your trip to Northwest Ontario, because man, you come once, you're gonna come for the rest of your life. Thanks for watching. We're gonna see you next time on Extreme Angler, maybe right here, back again with Merrill and Terry on this beautiful lake. See you next time.